Now let's see SLR parser in compile edition. Let's solve this problem. Construct SLR parsing table for the following grammar. E produces E plus T or T. T produces T star F or F. F produces left parenthesis E right parenthesis or ID. Also parse the input string. id star id plus id. Okay, here before constructing SLR parse table, first we have to calculate canonical collection of LR of 0 items, and then we need to design finite automata, followed by SLR parsing table construction, followed by parsing of the input string. Before calculating canonical collection of LR of 0 items, first we have to write augmented grammar. Here in augmented grammar, we have to add an extra production called start symbol dash produces start symbol. Suppose if S is the start symbol, then the extra production that is added is S dash produces S. Whereas in this example, E is the starting symbol. So we have to add an extra production called E dash produces E. So this grammar is known as augmented grammar. So first we have to write the augmented grammar. Augmented grammar. So the first production that is added is start symbol dash produces start symbol. Here E is the start symbol because this is the first production, left hand side non-terminal. So E dash produces is the new production which we are adding, and the remaining productions are as it is. So we need to write the remaining production same. So the next production is E produces E plus T. Next one R E produces T. Next one T produces T star F. Next one T produces F. So we have two productions for T. T star F is the first one. F is the second one. So next one for F also we have two productions. F produces left parenthesis E right parenthesis. So F produces ID is the productions. So this is nothing but augmented grammar. Okay. After that we have to calculate canonical collection of LR of 0 items. So let us calculate canonical collection. So this is nothing but step 1. So what is step 1? Calculate canonical collection of LR of 0 items. LR of 0 items. Okay. So here item means there is a dot symbol at right end of the production. If there is a dot symbol at right side of the production, then it is called as an item. So here the first production is E dash produces. Here this is an item. So we have to add dot at beginning of the right side production. So here we need to add dot here, dot. So what is the non-terminal here? E. So this is nothing but an item. Item means there is a dot at right side of the production. Here, if there is a non-terminal after the dot symbol, then we have to write the productions of the non-terminal. Here we have capital E after the dot symbol. So we need to write the productions of E. The productions of E are E produces E plus T, E produces T. But this is an item. Item means we need to add dot at beginning of the right production. So E produces dot E plus T, and the next one is E produces dot T. Next, if we consider this production, after dot we have a non-terminal called capital E, but already capital E productions are included, so there is no need to write E productions one more time. If we consider this production, after dot we have a non-terminal called capital T. So we need to write the productions of T. So the productions of T are T produces T star F, T produces F. but this is an item, so we have to add dot at beginning of the production. So T produces dot T star F. Next one, T produces dot F. Here, if we consider this production, T produces dot T star F. After dot, we have a non-terminal called T. But already the productions of T are included. So there is no need to write T productions one more time. Whereas if we consider the second production of the T, after dot, we have a non-terminal called capital F. So we have to write the productions of F now. So F produces, so this is an item. So include dot symbol, so dot, left parenthesis E, right parenthesis. And the other production is F produces, this is an item. So we need to add dot at beginning of the right production. So if we consider this production, after dot we have left parenthesis. But there is no production for left parenthesis. Likewise, if we consider last production, after dot we have a terminal symbol id, but there is no production for id. So this is nothing but I naught state. Let us assume that the state has I naught. Why? Because after that we have to design the finite automata as well as we have to construct the parse table. So while designing the finite automata and while constructing the parse table, we need to use make of those states. Those states. So here the first state is I naught. Okay. So next, let us calculate go to. So go to of. Here, what is the state here? I naught is the state. I naught comma. Here after dot we have a non-terminal called capital E. So apply E on I naught. If you take the next production. In the next production also, after dot we have capital E. So apply E on I naught. Next, after dot we have T. After dot we have T. So apply T on I naught. Next, after dot we have F. Apply F on I naught. After dot we have left parenthesis. So apply left parenthesis on I naught. After dot we have ID. Apply ID on I naught. Okay. So go to of I naught comma E. So we have to apply this go to formula on the productions which contains capital E after the dot. So the first production as well as in the second production we have capital E before after the dot symbol. So apply go to on these two productions. Whenever we apply go to, then what will happen is dot will be shifted one position to the right. So E dash implies dot E will become E dash produces E dot. E dash produces E dot, because dot will be shifted one position to the right. Here after dot we don't have any non-terminal, so there is no need of any expansion. And apply this formula, this go to on this production also, because after dot we have capital E. So if we apply go to on this production, then dot will be shifted one position to the right. So the production will become E produces E dot plus T. E produces E dot plus T. Here after dot we have a plus symbol. For plus there is no production. Okay. So go to of I naught comma E is over. So let us assume the state as I naught is over. So I1. Next calculate. Go to of I naught comma. So what is the next symbol after dot? T. So we have two productions which contains capital T after the dot. So apply go to formula on these two productions. So if we apply go to on this production, then dot will be moved one position to the right. So the production will become E produces dot E will become T dot. Next, if we apply go to on this production, then dot will be moved one position to the right. So the production will become T produces T dot star F. T produces T dot star F. Here after dot we don't have any non-terminal. Here also after dot we don't have any non-terminal. So there is no need of expanding that non-terminal because we don't have the non-terminal. So go to of I naught comma T is over. So let us assume this state as I2. So next go to of I naught comma. So what is the next symbol after the dot? We have F after the dot. So we have only one production which contains F after the dot. So apply go to on that production. So whenever we apply go to, then what will happen? Dot will be moved one position to the right. So T produces dot F will become T produces F dot. So go to of I naught comma F is over. So let us assume the state as I2 is over, so I3. Next, go to of I naught comma. Here after dot we have left parenthesis. So apply left parenthesis on I naught. So then what will happen? So F implies, so dot will be shifted one position to the right. So the production will become F implies left parenthesis dot E, right parenthesis. Here after dot we have a non-terminal. So we have to write the productions of E. If there is a non-terminal after the dot symbol, then we have to write the productions of that non-terminal. So what are the productions of non-terminal? E produces, this is an item. So we need to add dot at beginning of the right side. So E produces dot E plus T. Next one, E produces dot T. E produces dot T. If we consider this production, after dot we have capital E, but already the productions of E are included. So there is no need to write one more time. Next production, E produces dot E. After dot we have a non-terminal called capital T. So write the productions of T. So T produces, so this is an item. So you add dot at beginning. T produces dot T star F. Next one, T produces, what is the other production for T? T produces dot F. So if we consider this production, after dot we have capital T. Already the productions of T are included. Next to T produces dot F. After dot we have capital F. Non-terminal capital F. So we have to write the productions of F. So what are the productions of F? F produces dot left parenthesis E right parenthesis. F produces dot I. Here after dot we have left parenthesis. No production for left parenthesis. After dot we have ID. So no production for ID. So let us assume this production as I3 is over. So let the next state is I4. So next one, go to of I0 comma. So left parenthesis is applied. So the next one is after dot we have ID. So go to of I0 comma ID. So whenever we apply go to, then what will happen? Dot will be shifted one position to the right. So the production will become F produces ID dot. So I4 is over. So let us assume the state as I5. I5. So this is nothing but I5. So till now we have processed all the productions of I0. So now we have to consider I1. So go to of I1 comma. So if we consider the first production, after dot we don't have any symbol. So there is no need to apply go to on this production. Here this production is called as final item. Final item means there is a dot symbol at end of the production. So if we consider this production, then the final item is E produces E plus T dot. If we consider this one, E produces T dot. Next one, T produces T star F dot. So in this problem, we need to produce all the productions as final items. Okay. So go to of I1 comma. Here after dot, we don't have any symbol. So there is no need to apply go to on this production. If you consider this one, after dot we have plus. So apply plus on I1 using go to. Then what will happen? Dot will be shifted one position to the right. So this production will become E produces E plus dot T. So dot will be shifted one position to the right. So E produces E plus dot T. Here after dot we have a non-terminal called T. So if there is a non-terminal after the dot symbol, then we have to write the productions of T. So what are the productions of T? T produces, this is an item. So include dot at beginning. Next one, T produces dot F. If you consider this one, after dot we have T, but already the productions of T are included. If you consider this one, after dot we have F. So write the productions of F. So F produces dot left parenthesis E. F produces dot I. So go to of I1 comma plus is over. So let us assume the state as I5 is over. So I6. So I1 productions are processed. Now let us consider I2. So go to of I2 comma. Here after dot we don't have any symbol. So there is no need to apply go to on this production. And this is called as final item because dot appears at end of the production. Next, if we consider this one, after dot we have asterisk. So apply asterisk on I2. Asterisk is nothing but multiplication operator. If we apply go to, then what will happen? Dot will be shifted one position to the right. So the production will become T produces T star dot F. Here after dot we have a non-terminal called capital F. So write the productions of F. So F produces dot left parenthesis E right parenthesis F produces dot I. So go to of I2 comma asterisk is over. So let us assume that the state yes I6 is over. So I7. So I2 productions are processed. Now let us consider I3. So I3 contains only final item. So there is no need to apply go to on this production. Now let us consider I4. So go to of I4 comma. Here after dot we have a non-terminal called E. So there are two productions which contains capital E after the dot symbol. So apply go to on these two productions. If we apply go to on the first production, then the production will become F produces left parenthesis dot will be moved one position to the right. So left parenthesis E dot right parenthesis. Here after dot we don't have any non-terminals. So there is no need of any expansion. Likewise, if we consider this one, then dot will be shifted one position to the right. So this production will become E produces E dot plus T. E dot plus T. After dot we have a terminal symbol. There is no non-terminal. So no need of any expansion. So let us consider this state as I8. I8. Okay. So in I4 after dot we have E. So that is applied. Next in the next production after dot we have T. So go to of I4 comma T. So there are two productions which contains capital T after the dot. So apply go to on these two productions. If we apply go to on this production, then the state will become, then the production will become E produces T dot. Next this one T produces dot T star F. So dot will be moved one position to the right. So the production will become T produces T dot star F. T dot star F. So if we consider I2, I2 is also E produces T dot, T produces T dot star F. So these two productions will come under I2. We should not give new name to these productions because already I2 state contains the same productions. So use that name only. So go to of I4 comma T is nothing but I2 only. So next one T produces dot F. So go to of. So what is the state? I4 is the state. Next after dot what is the input we have? F. So go to of I4 comma F. Then what will happen? Dot will be moved one position to the right. So T produces F dot. So T produces F dot is nothing but the state I3. So we have to give I3 as the state name for this production. Don't give new name, because that state is already existing with that production. So next one, go to of I4 comma. So this one is over. Here after dot we have left parenthesis. So go to of I4 comma left parenthesis. So then what will happen? F produces dot will be moved one position to the right. So left parenthesis E right parenthesis. F produces left parenthesis dot E right parenthesis. So this is nothing but I4. Here after dot we have capital E. So what we have to do? We need to write the productions of E. So E produces dot E plus T. E produces dot T. If we consider this one, after dot we have T. So we need to write the productions of T. Here after dot we have F. So we need to write the productions of F. So this is nothing but here for space constraints I'm using some quotation. So quotation is nothing but all these productions. So what is this state? So this state is nothing but I4. So here, what is double quotation? This double quotation represents all these projections. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next one, go to of I4 comma. So left parenthesis is applied. After dot, we have ID. So go to of I4 comma ID. So the projection will become F produces ID dot. So F produces ID dot is nothing but the state I5. So don't give new name, because already that state exists with that name. So with this, all the productions of I4 are processed. Now let us consider I5. I5 contains final item only. So there is no need to apply, go to another production. Now let us consider I6. So go to of I6 comma. So here after dot, what is the symbol we have? T. So apply T on I6 with the help of go to. There are two productions which contains T after the dot. So this one and this one. So apply go to on these two productions. Then E produces E plus dot T will become E plus T dot. Next to T produces dot T star F will become T dot star F. Up to 8 is over. So let us consider this state as I9. I9. So next one, go to of I6 comma. I6 comma T is over. So what is the next symbol? After dot we have F. So go to of I6 comma F. So the production will become T produces F dot. So T produces F dot is nothing but the state I3. So next one, go to of I6 comma. I6 comma after dot we have left parenthesis. So go to of I6 comma left parenthesis. So the production will become F produces left parenthesis dot E right parenthesis. So F produces left parenthesis dot E right parenthesis is nothing but the state I4. I4. Next one, go to of I6 comma ID. Go to of I6 comma ID. So dot will be moved one position to the right. So F produces ID dot. F produces ID dot is nothing but the state number. So what is the state number? I5. 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 So the productions of I6 are processed. Now let us consider I7. I7. So go to of I7 comma. Here after dot we have F. So only one production contains F after the dot. So apply that. So T produces T star dot F will become F dot. So this production is not available in any state. So this, so now the state will become I9 is over. So what is the next state? I10 is the next state. I10 is the next state. Next one, go to of I7 comma after dot we have left parenthesis. So go to of I7 comma after dot we have left parenthesis. So the production will become F produces left parenthesis dot E right parenthesis. So this is nothing but I4. I4. Next one, go to of I7 comma after dot we have ID. So the production will become F produces ID dot. F produces ID dot is nothing but I5. So the productions of I7 are processed. So now let us consider I8. So go to of I8 comma. After dot we have right parenthesis. So if we apply right parenthesis, then what will happen? Dot will be moved one position to the right. So F produces left parenthesis E dot. Here after dot we don't have any symbol. So let us assume this as I11, because I10 is over. So the next one is I11. Next one, here after dot we have plus. So go to of I8 comma. After dot we have plus. So the production will become E produces E plus dot T. So next we have to write T productions. Next we have to write F productions. E produces E plus dot T. So this is nothing but I6. I6. So go to of I8 comma plus is over. I8 comma plus is over. Next one, I2 productions are already processed. I3 productions are already processed. I4 productions already processed. I5 productions already processed. Next one, this one is nothing but I9. So we have to process I9 productions now. So go to of I9 comma, this is nothing but final item. If you consider this one, after dot we have star. So go to of I9 comma star. So now what will happen? I9 comma star. So dot will be moved one position to the right. So T produces T star dot F. Next we have to write the productions of F. So T produces T star dot F. That is nothing but I7. So that is nothing but I7. So next go to of I9 productions are processed. I3 productions processed. I4 productions processed. I5 processed. I10 contains final item only. I4 already processed. I5 already processed. I11 contains final item only. So this is nothing but I11. I6 already processed. So this is nothing but step 1. So what is step 1? Calculating canonical collection of LR of 0 items. So now we have to design the finite automata. So designing of the finite automata is very very simple. So here what is the first state? I0 is the first state. So go to of I0 comma E means I1. So if we apply E on I0, then we will get I1 state. So if we apply E on I0, then we will get I1 state. Next one, go to of I0 comma T means I2. So if we apply T on I0, then we will get I2 state. Next one, go to of I0 comma F means I3. So if we apply F on I0, then we will get I3. Next one, go to of I0 comma left parenthesis means I4. So if we apply I0 on left parenthesis, then we will get I4. So next one, I0 id means I5. So I0 id means I5. Next one, I1 plus means I6. I1 plus means I6. So next one, I2 asterisk means I7. Next one, I4 is equal to means I8. Next one, I4 T means I2. Next one, I4 F means I3. Next one, I4 left parenthesis means I4. Self loop. I4 ID means I5. I6 T means I9. Next one, I6 F means I3. Next one, I6 left parenthesis means I4. So likewise, we have to establish the remaining connections also. So designing the finite automata is very very simple one. If we have LR of 0 items, then it is very very easy to design the finite automata. Now let's see the next step. Construction of SLR. So here the productions are E produces E plus T, E produces T, T produces T star F, T produces F, F produces left parenthesis E, right parenthesis, F produces ID. Here before constructing the SLR parse table, we have to find out follow of the non-terminals. Okay. Here in order to calculate the follow, there is no need to eliminate left recursion as well as no need to eliminate left factoring. Directly we can calculate follow on the corresponding productions. So what is follow of E? So follow of E is equal to, here after E we have plus symbol and after E we have right parenthesis. So plus right parenthesis, for the starting symbol we have to add dollar. So follow of E is nothing but plus right parenthesis dollar. Next we calculate follow of T. So what is follow of T? Follow, here after T we have asterisk symbol, asterisk. Next in the right hand side we have T here, we have T here. So follow of T is nothing but follow of E. So what is follow of E? Plus right parenthesis dollar. Next we calculate F. So what is follow of F? So follow of F is nothing but follow of T. So what is follow of T? Star plus right parenthesis and dollar. Okay. Next we have to construct the parse table. Here totally we have 12 states from 0 to 11. So states are nothing but here rows. So 0 is the first state, next one 1, next to 2. So likewise we have 11 states. So 2, next one 3, next 4, next 5, next 6, next 7, next one 8th state, next one 9, next 10, and the last one is 11. So these are nothing but state numbers. Next here we have two columns. The first column represents the action column, whereas the second column represents go-to part. So the action part, go-to part. The action part is represented with the help of terminal symbols. So what are the terminal symbols presented in the grammar? So here this is nothing but 0 row. So the terminal symbols are, we have id, next we have plus, next star, next one left parenthesis, next one right parenthesis, and we need to take dollar. So this is nothing but the action part, and go to part is represented with the help of non terminals. So the non terminals are E, T and F. So now we have to construct the parse table now. Okay, so let us consider the first one. So go to of I naught comma E means I1. So I naught is nothing but 0 state, whereas I1 is nothing but 1. So 0 E, if we apply E on 0, then we will get 1. So 0 E means 1. Next one, go to of I naught comma T means I2. So if we apply T on I0, then we will get 2. So 0 T means 2. Next one, go to of I0 comma F I3. So 0 F means 3. Next one, I0 left parenthesis means 4. Left parenthesis is a symbol, a terminal symbol. So if it is a terminal symbol, then we have to perform shift operation. Here mainly we perform 4 actions. Shifty action, reduce action, accept action, and error action. Okay, so if it is a terminal symbol, then we need to perform shift operation. So shifty action is denoted with the help of S. So here left parenthesis means terminal symbol. So perform this shift action. Here what is the state number? 4 is the state number. So 0 left parenthesis means S4. 0 left parenthesis means S4. So next one, 0 id means, id is also terminal symbol, so perform shift operation. So 0 id means S5. So what is this one? This one is nothing but S5. Next one, 1 plus means 6. Here plus is nothing but terminal symbol, so perform shift. So 1 plus means S6. So next one, 2 asterisk means 7. So 2 asterisk means, here asterisk is nothing but a symbol, a terminal symbol. So shift operation. So 2 asterisk means S7. So next one, 4 capital E means 8. 4 capital E means 8. Next one, 4 T means 2. 4 capital T means 2. Next one, 4 F means 3. 4 F means 3. Next one, 4 left parenthesis means, here this is nothing but terminal symbol, so perform the shift. So 4 left parenthesis means S4. Next one, 4 id means S5. 4 id means S5. Next one, 6 t means 9. 6 t means 9. Next one, 6 f means 3. 6 f means 3. Next one, 6 left parenthesis is a symbol, so 6 left parenthesis means S4. Next one, 6 id means, id is a terminal symbol, so shift S5. Next one, 7 f means 10, so 7 f means 10. Next one, 7 left parenthesis means S4. 7 left parenthesis means S4. Next one, 7 id means S5. Next one, 8 right parenthesis means right parenthesis is a symbol. So 8 right parenthesis means S11. Next one, 8 plus is a symbol. So 8 plus means S6. Next one, 9 asterisk is a symbol. So 9 asterisk means S7. Okay. Next we have to searches for final items. So in which state we have the final items? Okay. Let us consider I0. In I0 we don't have final item. So final item means dot should present at end of the production. I1 contains one final item. So that is, so I1, what is the final item here? E dash implies E dot. E dash produces E dot. So here what is the state number? 1 is the state number. So we have to consider 1 here. So whenever we apply dollar on one state, then the corresponding input string is accepted by the parser. In every SLR parser technique, in every SLR parser example, in the parsing table, $1 contains accepted state. Why? Because for that purpose only we have added this production. Because we know that end of the input string contains dollar, whereas this item is available in the state number 1. So $1 means there are no more items in the input string. Input string is empty. So $1 means the corresponding string is accepted by the finite automata. Now let us check whether I2 contains any final items or not. I2 contains one final item. So what is that item? So I2, E produces T dot is the final item. So now we have to search for this production number. So let us give the production numbers here. So this is nothing but 0, because this is the additional production that we have added. Next 1, 2, so this is nothing but 7. So 2, next one 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So E produces T is nothing but the production number 2. Here we have to perform reduce operation, R2, okay, R2. Here where we have to add that R2. For that purpose, here we need to calculate follow of the left hand side non-terminal. So what is follow of E? Plus right parenthesis dollar. Plus right parenthesis dollar. So here the process is very, very simple. We have to search for the final items. I2 state contains a final item called E produces T dot. So we have to take the state number. E produces T is nothing but 2 here. So R2. So where we need to add R2? For that purpose, we need to calculate follow of the left hand side non-terminal. So follow of E is nothing but plus right parenthesis and dollar. Okay. So we have to take I2 state now. So in which columns we have to add plus right parenthesis and dollar. Okay. So what we have to add? R2. Okay. So this is over. Now, so there are no more final items in I2. So let us consider I3. So I3 also contains one final item. So I3, what is that item? T produces F dot. So T produces F is nothing but the state number 4. So we have to add R4 now. Why? Because T produces F is nothing but state number 4, R4. So where we need to add, we have to calculate follow of the T now. So follow of T is nothing but star plus right parenthesis and dollar. So what is the state number here? 3 is the state number. So in which columns we have to add? Plus star right parenthesis and what is the next one? Dollar. Far off the left hand side non-terminal. So star plus right parenthesis and dollar. So what we need to add? R4. So I3 is over. Next let us consider I4. I4 doesn't contain any final item. So let us consider I5. So I5 contains final item. So what is that item? So I5, F produces ID dot. So F produces ID is nothing but the state number 6. So R6. So where we need to add, we have to calculate follow of F. So follow of F is nothing but star plus right parenthesis and dollar. So what is the state number here? 5 is the state number. So star plus right parenthesis and dollar. So R6. So I5 is over. Now let's check for I6. I6 doesn't contain any final items. Next I7. I7 also doesn't contain any final item. I8 also doesn't contain any final item. Next one. So this is nothing but I2. I2 is already calculated.
So I3 already processed. Next one I4 already processed. I5 already processed. Next one I9. I9 contains a file item. So what is that item? I9. E produces E plus T dot. So E produces E plus T is nothing but production number 1. So R1. So where we have to add? We need to calculate fall of E. So what is fall of E? Plus right parenthesis and error. So here what is the state number? So 9 is the state number. So where we need to add fall of E plus right parenthesis dollar. Okay. Here in order to add that, we have to calculate fall of the left hand side non-derivative. So what is fall of E plus right parenthesis and dollar? So plus right parenthesis and dollar. Okay. So R1. So R1. Okay. So I9 is over. Now let us consider I10. I10. So where is I10? So we have I10 here. So this is also contains final item. I10. So T produces T star F dot. So T produces T star F is nothing but the state number R3. R3. So in which column we have to add? We need to calculate fall of the left hand side non-terminal. So what is fall of T star plus right parenthesis and other? So the state number is I10. So star plus right parenthesis and dollar. So R3. So plus star right parenthesis and dollar R3. So what is this one? This one is nothing but R1. Okay. Next one, let us search for next state I4. This is nothing but I4 already processed. Next one I5 already processed. I11. I11 also contains final item. So what is I11? So I11 F produces left parenthesis E dot. So F produces left parenthesis E is nothing but R5. So what is the state number? 11 is the state number. So what is the fall of F star plus right parenthesis and dollar? So what is the reduction number? R5. So we have shifty entries, reduction entries, as well as accepted entries. So the remaining entries are nothing but error entries. So this is about SLR parse table. Now we have to parse the input stream. So here we have three columns. The first column is nothing but stack. Next column, input stream. Next column, action. So before that, we need state numbers here. Here, 0 is nothing but E dash implies E. So this is not needed. So 1 means E produces E plus T. 2 means E produces 3. E produces T. Next one, T produces T star F. Next one, T produces F. Next fifth one, F produces left parenthesis E, right parenthesis. F produces ID is nothing but sixth state. Okay. This is nothing but the action. So which action we are performing? So initially, the bottom of the stack contains dollar symbol. Let the input string is ID star ID plus ID. End of the input string contains dollar. Initially, we have to push state number 0 onto the top of the stack. So 0. So 0 is the stack's topmost element. Input symbol is ID. So 0 ID means S5. So S means shift 5. Here, while performing the shifting, first we have to shift input symbol onto the top of the stack and then shift the state number. So first shift input symbol and then shift state number. So ID is shifted up to the top of the stack. So the remaining input string is star ID plus ID dollar. So next to 5 asterisk. So what is 5 asterisk? So 5 asterisk means R6. So reduce. So what is the 6 production number? F produces ID. If the right hand side contains one symbol, then we have to pop stack's topmost 2 symbols from the stack. If the right hand side contains one symbol, then we have to pop
two symbols from the stack. Why? Because while shifting, while pushing also, we are pushing two symbols. First one is input symbol and the next one is state number. So here also, while performing reduction also, we need to pop two symbols. Whereas if the right hand side contains two symbols, then how many symbols we have to pop? 2 into 2. So 4 symbols we have to pop. So here the right hand side contains how many symbols? 1 symbol. So we need to pop stack's topmost 2 symbols. So pop these 2 symbols. So $. So what is the stack's topmost element now? 0 after popping. And we need to apply 0 on the left hand side non-terminal. So what is the left hand side non-terminal? F. So 0 F means 3. Here while pushing also, while shifting also, we need to shift 2 symbols. So first the non-terminal and then the state. So what is the state number? 3 is the state number. So 0 F means F3. So first shift non-terminal and then shift state number. So 0 F3. So what is the next remaining one? So star ID plus ID $. Next one, 3 asterisk. So 3 asterisk means R4. R4. So what is R4? So fourth production. P produces F. So right hand side contains how many symbols? 1 symbol. So we have to pop stack's topmost symbols, topmost 2 symbols. Why? Because right hand side contains 1 symbol. So $. 3 is popped, F is popped. So stack's topmost element is 0. So apply 0 on left hand side non-terminal T. So 0 T means T2. So first we have to shift non-terminal and then shift state number. So 0 T2. So input string same. So star ID plus ID $. So 2 asterisk. So 2 asterisk means S7. So shift 7. Shift 7. So $. 0 T2. While shifting, first we have to shift the input symbol and then shift the state number. What is the input symbol? Asterisk. So first shift that input symbol and then shift the state number. So the remaining input string is ID plus ID $. Next, 7 ID. So 7 ID means S5. 7 ID means S5. So $. 0 T2 star 7. So while shifting, first we have to shift the input symbol and then shift state number. So the remaining is ID shifted. So the remaining is plus ID $. Okay, 5 plus. So 5 plus means R6. So what is sixth production? F produces ID. So F produces ID. So right hand side contains only 1 symbol. So we have to pop stack's topmost 2 elements. So $. 0 T2 star 7. So 5 is popped, ID is popped. So stack's topmost element is 7. Apply 7 on F. So 7 on F means, 7 on F means this one. So F10. F10. So 7F. 7F. F10. So plus ID $. So 10 plus. So 10 plus means R3. R3. So what is star production number? T produces T star F. T produces T star F. Here the right hand side contains 3 symbols. So T is the first one, asterisk is the second one, F is the third one. So right hand side contains 3 symbols. So we need to pop 6 symbols from the stack. So these two are the first two. These two are next two. These two are next two. So 2 plus 2, 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. So after popping these 6 symbols, stack's topmost element contains 0. So apply 0 on the left hand side non-terminal, that is T. So 0 T means T2. So first we need to shift the non-terminal and then state number. So 0 T2. So next one plus ID $. So next to 2 plus. So 2 plus means R2. So reduce. So what is second production number? What is the second production? E produces 2. E produces T. Because 2 plus means what? R2. So what is 2? E produces T. So right hand side contains only 1 symbol. So we have to pop stack's topmost 2 elements. So $0. So apply 0 on E. So 0 E means E1. E1. Next plus ID dollar. So 1 plus means S6. So shift 6. So dollar 0 E1. So shift plus onto the top of the stack. So remaining input string after plus, we need to shift state number also. So ID dollar. Next 6 ID. So 6 ID means shift 5. Shift 5. So dollar 0 E1 plus 6. We need to shift 5. So first shift the input symbol and then shift state number. So now ID is shifted. So input buffer is empty. Dollar. So $5. So $5 means R6. So what is R6? Reduce F produces ID. So stacks. So we need to eliminate stacks topmost two elements because right hand side contains only one symbol. So dollar 0 E1 plus 6. So 5 is eliminated, ID is eliminated. So stacks topmost element is 6. So $6 means. So 6 here reduce operation. So 6 we have to apply 6 on F. So 6F means. 6F means F3. F3. So dollar. So $3. So $3 means R4. R4. So what is R4? So reduce T produces F. So right hand side contains only one symbol. So eliminate, delete the stack's topmost two elements. So dollar 0 E1 plus 6. So apply 6 on T. So 6T means 6T means T9. T9 dollar. So 9. So here $9 means, so this is nothing but 9 and this is nothing but dollar. So $9 means R1. So what is R1? Reduce with E produces E plus T. So right hand side contains how many symbols? So 1, 2, 3, 3 symbols. So we have to pop stacks topmost 6 elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So dollar 0. So now the stacks topmost element is 0. So apply 0 on E. So 0 E means E1. E1. So dollar. So next one. $1 means. So what is $1? So $1 is nothing but accepted. So for that purpose here we use this one. So S dash implies S dot means in the I1 state for dollar location, for dollar entry, we need to add accepted. So we can say that this input string is accepted by the SLR parser. So this is about SLR parser.